Greetings, fellow citizens. The next ship we are testing is the Drake Caterpillar. And here she is in the pirate skin. This video was sponsored by Jack Axton, and he always tries to sell Drake ships to everyone. Look at this.
Everyone always wants a carrier. I feel like this is the first carrier actually made for civilians. Obviously, Drake has a massive history of catering to civilians. Civilians are always asking for something to carry other ships around. I was hoping, as you can see, I've got the Kraken logo down here, and looks like Drake finally came through for us.
And we are starting with one SAS-1 missile. Looks like slow motion time, I think 99 front. And we are shooting one SAS-2 missile. Looks like 99 front side, stern at maximum. And we are shooting one SAS-3 missile. Shields front side 98, stern at maximum. And we are shooting one SAS-4 missile. Looks like 96 front side, stern at maximum. Next we are firing 6 SAS-4 missiles. Looks like shield front side 75 stern at maximum. And now comes the funny part. Shield's front side was still at 75%, but the front of the ship is red. And this is not a graphic bug, this is real damage as far as I can tell. Something is very strange here, Chris. What have you done? And we are shooting 6 SAS-4 missiles one more time to make sure. Shields front side 75, stern at maximum, and again the front of the ship is red and I guess lost a lot of hit points. We cannot see any cosmetic damage. I think cosmetic damage is not in game since 3.0, so not ported to item 2.0, I think. So what do we make of this? The Caterpillar was the only ship in 3.2.x that took damage even though the shields were still up. And now the shields were still at 75%, but the Caterpillar took massive damage to its front. I think this is a bug. Interesting. Let's see what we can still do. This thing is sluggish, as it should be. Normal SM speed, afterburner. As far as I can tell, this is normal flight control. And we have our guns. And we are shooting one SAS-5 torpedo. Ninety-four front side, stern at maximum. And we are shooting two SAS-5 torpedoes. Eighty-something front side, stern at maximum. And the front of the ship is red. Shields still at 87% front side stern max, but the front of the ship took massive damage. This is a bug, no doubt about it. I heard stories of Caterpillar pilots who told me their ships got destroyed even though the shields were still at way above 50%. And we are shooting one SAS-9 torpedo. Looks like 82 front side, stern at maximum. And we are shooting two size 9 torpedoes. Shields 66-ish, front side stern at maximum, and again the front of the ship is red while the shields were still way above 60%. This doesn't make any sense, Chris. I hope it's just a bug. And we are doing it one more time, two size 9 torpedoes. Looks like 66 front side stern at maximum, and again the front of the ship is red. So we are shooting two size 9 torpedoes, this time at the rear. Let's see if we have the same problem. No, okay. There's something wrong with the front of the Caterpillar. I have to watch this in slow motion, but two size 9 torpedoes aimed at the rear don't already put the rear into the red. That's interesting. And we are shooting three size 9 torpedoes. Looks like shield front side 52, stern at maximum, and again the front of the ship is red already, even though the shields were way above zero, 50-ish still. Let's see what we can still do. We have normal SCM speed and afterburner. This looks like normal flight controls. And we have our guns. And the next funny thing or sad thing is, the Caterpillar is already in a damaged state. After being hit by three size 9 torpedoes, and the shields are still at 50-ish percent front side standard maximum. So we have warning lights, sparks. Something is wrong with the shape of the Caterpillar. It takes way too much damage. I guess a long front messes up the damage model, and CRG has to do something here. It's not urgent, not now, but it would be a good idea to address this. The damage state looks interesting though. And we are shooting three size 9 torpedoes, this time at the rear. Firing. Looks like 52 stern side, front at maximum. And the stern of the ship has some red spots already. And we are in a damaged state. This doesn't make much sense, because all size 3 large shields should give a really big health pool now, and the Reclaimer was not in a damaged state after being hit by 3 size 9 torpedoes. Interesting. And we are shooting 4 size 9 torpedoes. Okay, this is very, very disappointing. So, we are shooting 4 size 9 torpedoes one more time to make sure. Yeah, it's a kill already. That's very disappointing after the buff to size 3 large shields. Chris! Well, it's just another bug, I guess. And next we are shooting 4 size 9 torpedoes one more time, this time to the rear, firing. And that's a kill as well. Interesting. So let's wrap this up and talk about the results. And I don't want to sound like a broken record, so I have those two memes. And I also would like to point out to those people who say, Ship X shouldn't be able to take a size 5 torpedo. I use missiles and torpedoes as a yardstick. I have tested now 13 ships in 3.3.0. And let's compare the Caterpillar to the Reclaimer. And as I told you in my previous videos, I now include default shield generator and default shield hit points in my data sheet. And you can see that Caterpillar and Reclaimer have about the same number of default shield hit points. And when we are looking at the missiles, this shows size 1 missile 99.99, size 2 missiles 99.99, size 3 missiles 98.98, size 4 missiles 95 and 75. Besides that one small detail that the Caterpillar already took massive damage to its front, even though the shields were still at 75%. This is a bug, plain and simple. I guess it has something to do with the silhouette, the shape of the Caterpillar, and maybe the shields don't cover this long shape, or maybe the shields don't cover the shape when they are getting a little bit down, when they shrink a little bit. So the Caterpillar takes massive damage, even though the shields were still at 75%, front, side, stern, max. And when we're looking at size 5 torpedoes, the same thing, 9487 and 9487. However, the front of the Caterpillar already took massive damage and it was red, even though the shields were still at 87%, front, side, stern, max. Again, it looks like there's something very wrong with the shape of the Caterpillar, or in other words, I guess CHA is still using only something like a ball shape shield and not a very tight shield. So the front of the Caterpillar is exposed to damage, even though the shields are still at 87%, and this is real damage. I heard from a lot of Caterpillar pilots that their ships got destroyed, even though the shields were still way above 50%. Now we all know this is an alpha, bugs are to be expected, and there's no reason to be worried. But this is something a Caterpillar pilot should keep in mind, and I hope that CHE will fix this in the next year. Now when we are looking at size 9 torpedoes, the numbers between the Caterpillar and the Reclaimer are very similar. It's very hard to read the exact number, and plus minus 1% is always something, and I don't care much about plus minus 1 or 2%. And next interesting thing is that two size 9 torpedoes aimed at the front of the Caterpillar mean shields 66% front, side, stern, max, and the front is already red and took massive damage again. And two size 9 torpedoes aimed at the rear. This was a suggestion of Jack. Thanks much, Jack. Shields 66% stern, side, front, max, and no red spot. So something is very wrong with the shape of the Caterpillar. Next, when we're looking at size 3 torpedoes, it doesn't matter if I aim at the front or at the stern. Shields 52% front, side, or stern, side, and stern max or front max, and damage state. And 4 size 9 torpedoes are kill, front hits and rear hits. And let's look at the comparison. Like other ships with size 3 shields, the Caterpillar benefits from the massive buff to S3 shields, which was necessary to save the Hammerhead. I talked about this in my previous video, Reclaimer, if you want to just check this out. And blue is a Caterpillar in 3.2. 2, and yellow is a Caterpillar in 3.3. And as you can see, the Caterpillar is a lot tougher now, but not that much actually. In 3.2, a Caterpillar was killed by 3 SS9 torpedoes, and now it's killed by 4. An interesting fact is, in 3.2, the shields were down to 32% when hit by 1 SS9 torpedo stern max, but no damage to the hull. And now the shields are at 62% when hit by 2 SS9 torpedoes, but the front takes massive damage, so I guess this is a bug. Hey, but I don't own a Caterpillar. No, I still care. As always, you can find a link to my spreadsheet in the description below. I hope you had fun watching this video and see you next time. Bye! I decided to put this at the end of my videos from now on. At the end of all my toughness videos. If you already know this stuff, then just skip it. So, how can you tell how tough a ship is? What factors are important? There are different factors. One is, how big is the shield generator, or in other words, how many shield hit points does your shield generator provide? You can find this information on Malocco's spreadsheet. The second thing is armor. Armor does provide a damage reduction depending on the type of attack. For instance, you can have a damage reduction against physical attacks of 30%. Right now, all ships only use a generic value. You can find this generic value in my local spreadsheet as well. And the third factor is, how many hit points do different parts of your ship have? For example, the body of a Constellation has 10,000 hit points. This data is a little bit tricky to find. You can find some of those numbers on my local spreadsheet, but the data is not very uniform. Some ships are just listed at one blob of hit points, and other ships have their parts, different parts with different numbers of hit points listed in a very detailed way. This is not Malocco's fault, he's getting the data right out of the game files. And next we have some factors, I will call them soft stats. For instance, how big is your ship? If your ship is very small, let's say a Buccaneer, and you get hit by 1 size 4 missile Raptor, then all 4 shield phases are affected and all 4 shield phases are working on damage migration. However, if your ship is a little bit bigger, let's see Aurora, and you are getting hit by 1 size 4 missile Raptor at the front, then only the front and side shields are working on damage migration, while the stern shield is just chilling away and does nothing for you. The effect is that the Buccaneer is not affected by 1 size 4 missile, it doesn't take any damage, while the Aurora takes damage and has a red hull after 1 size 4 Raptor impact at the front. And the last soft factor is, how easily are certain parts of your ship getting destroyed? For instance, some ships are prone to losing wing and wing guns even after a hit that wasn't that damaging. So this was a short summary of how tough is my ship. Some of those values you can find at Malocco's spreadsheet, but for the other values there's no way to find out about them. The only way is to shoot real missiles and torpedoes at real ships and observe what happens. And this is what I'm doing.